Yeah, Vegeta got his arm broke, or was it both arms? I can't remember.
Piccolo's fusion. After assessing the situation on Earth, Kami reluctantly agrees to fuse with Piccolo. In an explosion of power, the two halves are made whole again, and Piccolo is transformed into a Super Namek. The new and improved Piccolo races to Master Roshi's house, where the androids have gone in their hunt for Goku. Now Piccolo must put his powers to the test as he faces the androids alone.
Alright, now we Piccolo.
Oh, it's you again. Don't you ever give up.
And we have this random, like,
using my fist.
Wow, isn't that like sync with Nail? Like, BS and being like sync with Nail? What the mess. Because isn't the big thing that Piccolo just feeds with Kami? Oh, really?
Getting bored.
That was a clear uppercut placement. Oh, come on. That timing. Ow. Come on. Come on. Okay. Rig you, 17. I win.
As the battle between Piccolo and Android 17 rages on, the evil force Kami warned of rears its ugly head.
Hello, Cell. Piccolo's fusion, yet we never got to see the... transformation, though.
The Time Chamber. The monster Cell, Dr. Gero's ultimate creation, has but a single goal. Only through the absorption of Android 17 and 18 can Cell become complete and achieve his perfect form. And now, the monster is one step closer to achieving that goal. He sweeps Piccolo aside and attacks Android 17. Unable to resist, the android is absorbed, and Cell's body begins its shocking transformation. Before Cell can set his sights on Android 18 and complete his transformation, Tien burst onto the scene. Summoning every ounce of his strength, he holds the monster at bay with his powerful tri-beam technique, giving Android 18 a chance to escape. Meanwhile, Trunks and Vegeta are hard at work within the hyperbolic time chamber, a special room in Kami's lookout in which a fighter can gain a year's worth of training in just one day.
I have to win. First couple suck. Come on. I will win, Vegeta. I will beat you, father. Really, controller? I almost won already, Jeeps. Come on, Vegeta. Is that all you got? I'm one away. Come on. I win!
Tien holds out against Cell for as long as he can, but at last, his strength fails him. But before Cell can reciprocate in kind, Goku suddenly appears on the scene. Using his instant transmission technique, he transports Tien and Piccolo back to the lookout for a quick recovery. At the same time, their years' worth of training completed, Trunks and Vegeta emerge from the hyperbolic time chamber, more powerful than ever.
Save over game one? Yeah, I've been doing that the entire time.
Imperfect Cell. Cell's frustration grows as his search for Android 18 proves fruitless. He has traced the android to a chain of deserted islands, and he begins destroying the islands one by one in an attempt to flush her from hiding. But before he can close in on his target, Vegeta and Trunks arrive on the scene, eager to put their training in the hyperbolic time chamber to the test.
Again, question marks, but okay, I can deal with this.
You don't even have a chance.
He's telling everyone because of the way he is. You come let block that good yourself. Confound it. Okay. Vegeta, did you ever think you'd fight the Cybermen that at one point worked for you, basically. That one didn't even get a chance. Nice.
Gallagher, no!
There are still enemies in this area.
Apparently.
Gallagher, no!
Confound me if I like
God. No! God, no!
Ba, ba, ba. Come on, Gandalf. Don't be chugging like that on me. And we now have the ordnance crew back. Lovely!
Gallagher, no!
Ow.
Gallagher, no!
Ah, my face!
Gallagher, no!
Whoa. Got that done? Let's continue, shall we? Let's see, coin. Let's see some energy capsules, a health capsule. What the mess? Ah. Two hits, really? Since when has the spawners had that move? I thought it was outside the range of that one. What the
fuck
is that? Yes, Cell?
Fool! You don't even have a chance!
Vegeta, shut your mouth. Nearly escaped the atomic blast. Or the blast atomic. And who? I'll show you how strong my Super Saiyan is, Cell. Oh. Come on.